We've spent this last week travelling around with Jesus, from him entering into Jerusalem on the colt with the crowds cheering, chasing out the moneylenders in the temple, to the Last Supper and Jesus praying in the garden before his arrest, and then the horrific events of Good Friday with the humiliation and the death of Jesus, and the horrible waiting then of Easter Saturday. But now we arrive on Easter Sunday. God of glory, by the raising of your Son, you have broken the chains of death and hell. Fill your church with faith and hope, for a new day has dawned and the way to life stands open in our Saviour Jesus Christ. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Hello everyone, and happy Easter. It is so great that we can join together and celebrate, even if it is in this rather strange, unusual way. And I hope that you will join in with all the songs and the hymns that we've got. I'm going to be speaking to us a little bit later on as well. And Elliot is going to be leading us in an agape, or a love feast, which is a way of breaking bread together, as Jesus did in so many different settings with so many people. You may like to join in at home and do some bread and wine or juice, depending on what time you're watching this. And you might want to just take part as Elliot takes us through the liturgy that has been written by Chris Thorpe of Dancers and Wayfarers. So we're going to begin our service together with the classic Easter hymn. Let's join together and sing, "Thine be the glory, risen, conquering Son."
Happy Easter to all of you. Good to be with you all on this Easter Day. I'm going to read now from the book of Acts, chapter 10, and from verses 34 to 43. And this is Peter speaking while he was in the house of Cornelius. Then Peter began to speak. I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts from every nation the one who fears him and does what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, announcing the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout the province of Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing those who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witnesses of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a cross, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all the people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Happy Easter! God made you and God made me. He made the world for us to see. God loves you and God loves me. And long ago, he sent his son to tell us so. Jesus showed us many things, to love and share and dance and sing, to learn and pray, to help and care. He promised he'd always be there. He died, but then he came back to life. Let's celebrate for his life. Amen.
Stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder how he could love me, a sinner condemned and clean. Stand amazed.
This good earth, enough for all, if we can share. Gracious God, we give you thanks for all the many blessings in our lives, and ask that you would bless us now as we share your good gifts. In Jesus' name, Amen. Loving God, you provide enough for everyone. This earth is fertile, fruitful, and abundant. But we are sometimes greedy, wasteful, and selfish. Many go hungry despite our plenty. Many are left outside while we enjoy a feast. But on the hillside, in the wilderness, with 5,000 and more hungry people, Jesus took the bread that they had, broke it, and gave thanks to you. He shared the bread so that no one should be left out, and they all ate and were satisfied. Blessed be God forever. Hurting God, you weep with our pains. You weep with our tears. When you see how we struggle and suffer, you long for our peace, yet we so often make war. You long for our healing and wholeness, yet so often we turn away from you. But at a wedding in Cana, when the wine ran out, Jesus asked them to fill the empty jars with water. And by your grace, water became wine. Sadness was turned to joy, and all were able to share in the best wine of all. Blessed be God forever. Dreaming God, you long for us to dream your dream of a world at peace, a people made one, a feast for all, where bread is broken and shared with companions on the road, where wine is blessed and shared with all who are hurting, and all are caught up together in the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The bread can be shared using the words, bread for the world to share. The wine can be shared using the words, the best wine, saved till now. So please now share with one another as we have our next song, which is Before the Throne of God Above. Gracious God, we thank you for your abundant love in creation, your compassionate healing touch in our hurting, your inspiration for our venturing. Thank you for bread and wine to share. Give us grace to follow in the footsteps of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Gospel reading today is from John chapter 20, beginning at verse 1, the empty tomb. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the other linen. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to where they were staying. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned towards him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her.
This year for Easter, we have two narratives running alongside each other. Neither of them shows favoritism. Both have changed the world. Both have a power that no human seems to be able to stop. But one ends with death, the other leads to life. The news of one brings fear and anxiety, the news of the other brings peace and hope. One reduces people to tears of sadness, one turns our sadness into joy. One is temporary, but the other is eternal. The choice before us today is simple. Which narrative are we going to choose to build our life on during these difficult days? In the Bible readings, we heard that there are two main human characters, Mary Magdalene in our Gospel reading and Peter in our Acts reading. Both went through difficult times, but through them both found purpose and grace. Mary, made famous thanks to Dan Brown popularising the idea that she was Jesus' wife in the film Da Vinci Code. Amazing how so many decided to accept this view based purely on the work of complete fiction with zero historical evidence. The other popular thing known about Mary Magdalene is that she was the ultimate story of redemption, a prostitute that turns her life around. Unfortunately, if you know that story, it isn't true either. Nowhere in the Bible does it refer to Mary Magdalene as a prostitute. The rumour started in the 6th century as three different women were decided to be the same, and this was confirmed by the then Pope, Pope Gregory the Great. It was not until 1969 the Catholic Church finally declared Mary Magdalene was not the same person as the penitent sinner in Luke's Gospel, and so not a prostitute. So who was she then? Well, we actually know very little about her as a person. The Bible doesn't tell us her age, status or family details. What we can assume from her name is that she was from a village called Magdala, which lies on the shore of Galilee. Presumably it was here where she heard of and encountered Jesus. We know thanks to Luke chapter 8 that Mary was devoted to following Jesus, as it says she was amongst a few other women that travelled around with Jesus and the 12 disciples from town to town and village to village. We also know that she received physical healing from Jesus. And most importantly, we know that she was there at the cross when he died, and she was the first to witness the resurrection. All four Gospels tell us this. And Peter, the fisherman, made into the fisher of men. The strong, act first, think later type, who's characterised by jumping out of the boat to walk on the water, or drawing his sword to protect Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, and cutting off the ear of the high priest. Peter also epitomised the phrase, "The spirit is willing, but the body is weak." He falls asleep when Jesus is praying. He denies even knowing Jesus in the courtyard outside the high priest's house. So what do we learn from these two very human and very different people? Mary, the nobody, who is not only healed, but is chosen by God to be the first person to see the resurrected Jesus. Peter, the typical Galilean, is not only forgiven, but reinstated as the rock on which the church will be built. Both found purpose and grace in Christ.
At the cross and at the empty tomb, Mary wept. In the courtyard, Peter fled and wept. But when they encounter the risen Christ, all those feelings of hurt or shame, they're gone. Mary turns to the risen Jesus and cries out, "Rabboni," and grabs hold of him, not wanting to let him go. When Peter is back on his boat and he sees the risen Jesus out on the beach, he dives straight out of the boat and he rushes to be with him again. So this Easter, which narrative are you going to follow? Are you going to listen to the one offered by our world, which leads to us feeling powerless and questioning why? Or are you going to accept the grace that is offered through the risen Christ and find purpose and meaning for your life, even in our isolation? In his first letter, Peter says these words: "Like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow. You may grow up in your salvation, now that you have tasted that the Lord is good. As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, 'See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame.' The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone." Let us choose again today to make this cornerstone the narrative on which our life is built. Let us rejoice and be glad because what God has done for us. And let us use this time to grow even closer to God, craving that spiritual milk. And let's allow the wonderful good news of the Easter narrative to shine through us and out into the storms of this life. On this Easter day, let us raise a hallelujah and make our praises heard, because our King is alive. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
up early, sing a little louder. A weapon is a melody, sing a little louder. And heaven comes to fight for me, I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. And up from the ashes, in hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. And up from the ashes, in hope will arise. Death is defeated.
Just lift up our current situation to the Lord our God, knowing that He does drive out the darkness amongst us. He does hold us in the middle of the mystery that we're going through. Lord God, we thank You that fear is defeated, death is defeated. Lord, we come to You now.
We come now to our time of prayer when I say, Lord, in Your mercy, please respond with the words, hear our prayer. Let us pray. In joy and hope, let us pray to the Father that our risen Saviour may fill us with the joy of His glorious and life-giving resurrection. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. That isolated and persecuted churches may find fresh strength in the good news of Easter. Be with us in our isolation. Help us to be one in spirit as we cannot be one in body. Help us to remember the many churches around the world for whom every day brings danger. We pray especially for our linked church in Rwanda today. Thank You for their faithfulness to You. Be with them as they face food shortages. Give wisdom to the authorities there as to how to get much needed supplies to those in need. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. That by His power, war and famine may cease through all the world. On this Easter day, we especially pray for an end to the coronavirus pandemic. We have learned through this how much Your children are one all around the world. We ask that You would speed the work of a vaccine and help us to continue to work together, recognising what is truly important in life. Comfort those who are mourning because of this virus and grant peace to those who are currently suffering with it. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. That according to His promises, all who have died in the faith of the resurrection may be raised on the last day. We remember especially this day those from within our own congregations that have died in the last year. For Jim Scrimshire, Mary Ridger, Roger Lind and Ella Lovett. Thank You for their example. Help us to live out our days following in the way of Christ. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. That He may send the fire of the Holy Spirit upon His people, so that we may bear faithful witness to His resurrection. Help us not to be a helpless people, but to use this time of isolation to grow closer to You, and to be Your salt and light to the communities we live in. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, You have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of Your Son. Grant that as His death has recalled us to life, so His continual presence in us may raise us to eternal joy through Christ our Lord. Amen. And we close by saying together the words our Saviour has taught us in its modern form. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be Your name. Your kingdom come, Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are Yours, now and forever. Amen. So
So we're coming towards the end of our service together, and we thought, what better way to finish than use that wonderful band that was recorded, that's called Feeding 2011, that I know some of you have been enjoying, and the wonderful instruments that we can hear in there, to really just finish our service with a wonderful celebration on this Easter Sunday. So we're going to have two songs from them, and please do dance and sing loudly. The advantage of being at home is that it doesn't matter, because no one else is going to see you. You're not going to poke somebody's eye out next to you. You're not confined in a pew. So you stand up, dance, sing, let's celebrate together on this wonderful Easter day.
Put your hands together. Come on, put your hands together.
Come on, put your hands together.
Lord, I lift your name. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I long to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth. Grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I long to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. So glad you came to save. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Come on, put your hands together. 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 Come on, put your hands together.
Come on, put your hands together.
Lord, I lift your name. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I long to sing your praise. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Would you like a final song? Let's stand up.
He is the Lord and he reigns on high. He is the Lord. Spoke into the darkness, created the light. He is the Lord. Who is like unto him?
gospel, O Lord, is the hope for our nation. You are the Lord. It's the power of God for our salvation. You are the Lord. We ask not for riches, but look to the cross. For our inheritance, give us the lost. You are the Lord. Show your power,
O Lord,
our God. Show your power,
O Lord, our God.
Send your power, send your power,
O Lord,
our God. Send your power,
O Lord,
our God. Send your power.
As we finish our time together, I just say that Bishop Richard, our new Bishop of Hereford, has asked us all to join him at 7 o'clock this evening to light a candle as a sign of Jesus, the light being in the world. So to finish, I'm going to use a blessing from the Agape feast that we enjoyed earlier. God, who longs for our healing, meet us in our hurting with your compassion. Jesus, who stands with us, touch us in our brokenness, that we may be made whole. Spirit, who anoints us with power, fill us with your grace, that we may reach out to others. The blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen. Happy Easter, everybody.